with galleries exhibiting the likes of cows suspended in formaldehyde, photographs of football fans, and all manner of unusual artifacts, for the layperson it's often hard to get to grips with what it all means and where the inspiration comes from. At the Whitechapel Gallery in London's East End, curators hope their latest exhibition, entitled Antechamber, will unravel the mystery and broaden art's appeal by revealing the process by which art, in all its forms, is created.
The whole point of the show was that the artists are able to contribute something of their own thought processes into the show. So it's a co-curation with the curators.
We wanted to choose people who we thought would respond to the idea. And I think for some artists, it's important that the finished work just can speak for itself and that's all they want. But we wanted people who would be interested in the idea of trying to bring something else into the exhibition space.
Five artists from around the world were invited to contribute works, and it's quite a varied bunch. British artist David Austin has created paintings that contain a kaleidoscope of images, all stemming from a childhood love of ancient artifacts. His paintings hang alongside unlabeled objects from the British Museum.
They would be giving two rooms to each artist, and that you'd use one room for showing that maybe these objects or whatever it was that, you know, interested you, and then your work would be in the other room, and so there'd be a link between the two. So that's where the title Antechamber came from.
Claude Heath decided to explore the representation of objects via the sensation of touch. He drew blindfolded whilst tracing the object's outline by hand.
What I've actually done is tried to map my sensations on a page and simultaneously as I'm having them. So it's a way of recording sensation.
But blindfolded, Claude?
There's never a chance that it's going to be anything like what you expect it's going to be. I mean, obviously.
One of the international contributions comes from Swiss photographer Annelise Sterber. She's expanded on the theme of the snapshot with enlarged photographs being projected onto the walls of the gallery. All good and worthy, but perhaps the most telling exhibit comes from Steve Pippin.
I'll know my number.
His mixed media contribution consists in part of a sofa, a satellite dish and TV remote control. Gallery visitors can sit and surf the airwaves, and in doing so they'll be able to experience firsthand the inspirations of the obviously laid-back artist. Curators are happy with their hybrid exhibition.
I hope it'll have a very broad appeal, and I hope by bringing in non-art things from the outside world that it'll it will broaden the appeal of the exhibition.
One thing's for sure, this sofa could be crowded, especially if there's a big game on TV.